Hi, how's it going?
Just fine.
Oh, awesome. Well, thank you very much for taking the time to do this interview.
Yeah, sure, no problem.
Oh, well, awesome. Well, anyways, as a longtime fan of the band, it's an absolute pleasure to be able to talk to you and talk about this amazing brand new album from Naglfar, and I just love what's going on here with this new album, and it's great to be able to talk to you about it.
Yeah, I mean, I'm glad you like it, and so.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, I really love what's happening here, and it feels like the right album to come out here in 2020, and it's such a great thing to be able to see that as well too, you know, like considering everything that's going on in the world right now, and obviously with it being such quite a bit of time since the last album. I mean, I'm really glad to see that this album still came out in 2020.
Yeah, I mean, we had worked for such a long time with it, and we just didn't feel like it was any point in postponing any release or anything like that. I mean, even if the situation is a bit weird at the moment, I think also it's a time where people need new music as well.
Oh, it really is. And, you know, considering everything that's going on right now, and so many people that are still not able to work or are working from home or whatever the case is, the fact that they can listen to something like this and be really able to actually appreciate it rather than just have it be background noise or something like that, just to actually be able to take that time and be able to appreciate this from start to finish, you know, under the circumstances, it's great to see that it did turn out that way.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, so.
And, you know, of course, with that, it's been a little over a month now since the album did finally come out. I mean, how does it feel to have the album out just over a month ago now?
Well, it feels really good. It has been a long process, so to finally have it released, it feels, you know, like we have like a weight is off my shoulders. And the feedback so far has been very good. And seeing as it was 8 years ago since our last album, there's always that thought, you know, that maybe people have forgotten about you. And since you get so many new bands coming up and so much music that you're have access to every day, so I mean, but it doesn't seem to be the case. People seem to be getting into it, so.
Oh, and I'm
that's
glad to hear that too, because there are so many great songs on this album, and it really does feel like this album is just so fresh and so inspired from the band. And again, just being able to have something like this in 2020 and having such a great display of where the band is at now, it's just so great to see that.
Ah, cool.
So, with that in mind, I mean, obviously, with it being 8 years between albums, what was it like to finally start working on this album?
Well, I mean, the thing is, we started working already back in 2014, to you know, the whole songwriting process. But we quickly came to realize that the way we had been working on previous albums didn't work out anymore due to family lives and you know, jobs and whatnot. What happened before, what we did on previous albums is that we used to meet up back at Marcus' place and sit in his home studio and write and record together. But then, as you know, you get older, you get other responsibilities in life. So it was more and more difficult to schedule those writing sessions. We just time just went by, so to speak. So we didn't. I mean, there was almost like a break between 2014 and up until 2 years ago when we really started to focus again. Since Century Media, our label, got in touch and said that if we're still interested in working together, they were interested as well. So that kind of put some fire back into it, so to speak.
Oh, and I'm glad to see that Century Media had the interest in the band as well, too. And, you know, that did kind of help rejuvenate what was going on within the band. And just like you said, yeah, I mean, there's so many things that can happen in life that, you know, be it work, be it family, be it other events that can sadly put things on the back burner when it comes to music. But, you know, just being able to find that time to be able to really work the way that you want things to be able to work. And, you know, even if you do have to change that, the fact that everything was still able to come together and just being able to get an album out like this, you know, when you really started getting work on it within the last couple of years, I mean, it's so cool to be able to see that, you know, getting that push from Century Media helped this album eventually come out.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, there was always an idea of having a new album, of course, but since we had fulfilled our obligations to Century Media with Teras, we were just not in a rush to start searching for a new label. And I mean, we still got offers to play live, you know, so we wanted to, those limited times we had to meet up, we wanted to focus on rehearsing for shows instead. So that's also a reason why it all took so long, that we were rather focusing on live shows than actually sitting down and writing, as we didn't feel like there was a rush doing it. But they absolutely helped when they got back in touch with us, for sure.
Oh, I can absolutely imagine when it comes to that. And yeah, I mean, again, just the fact that everything was coming together like that is such a great thing. And again, just like the music that I'm hearing here, I mean, it's so great to be able to hear the band in form like this in 2020, because it really feels like it has so many classic moments from the band, but it also just feels so fresh and rejuvenated as well, too. It feels like it's almost hitting different territories while still being yourselves.
Oh, well, I'm glad you think that way. I mean, I haven't thought that much about it. I'm just focusing on writing music that I want to listen to myself. So if it's still relevant, that's just cool.
Oh, yeah. And yeah, I mean, just being able to have that full album experience, too, you know, from start to finish. I mean, it feels like that great classic album from the band. And, you know, it's so cool to see that. And, you know, getting back into the writing that you were talking about there, like when you were writing, I mean, what was that like when everything was starting to come together and Century Media was kind of help push everything? I mean, what was it like to know that the album was really starting to come to fruition?
Well, I mean, it's been a long process, and it actually has been kind of exhausting, I would say. So when you were finally seeing, you know, the light at the end of the tunnel, it was, it's hard to describe. It was a big relief, you know. It felt awesome to finally be done, you know. And so, yeah, it was just, I would say, a sense of relief. And I would say pride as well. You know, I'm very proud of the album and the outcome of it. So it's.
And with that in mind, I mean, obviously with so many changes that can happen with almost a decade's time, especially when it comes to technology and recording, what was it like this time around to be able to go into the studio and record this album?
Well, the thing is, you know, we recorded at Marcus' studio this time, so that was both a blessing and a curse. I mean, it's very convenient to have your own studio without having to take, you know, any financial issues or schedules in consideration. But it also can be, you know, a negative in the aspect that you tend to focus maybe on details, or, you know, you're not as focused as you should be. But I mean, it's been very cool with the new technology to be able to, you know, have the drummer record his parts in his studio, and I can maybe sit in writing stuff in my studio, and then just being able to send it, you know, send the files over, or, you know, share it through cloud storage. You know, it's It has been, that port was very convenient, I would say.
Oh yeah, and especially with where the band is at right now too, and not always being able to take the time to be able to get together and practice, especially the way that it used to be. I mean, I can only imagine that convenience factor felt so good to be able to send files back and forth, send riffs back and forth, and just really know where everything can go together. And yeah, being able to record drums in one place, being able to record almost everything else in another, and just being able to have it come together. And it still feels like the band recorded it in the studio all together. And it's just, it's so cool to be able to hear that.
Yeah. I mean, it's, I'm very pleased with the final results. And I think, you know, sound wise as well, I mean, we're always trying to focus on, we always previously tried to focus, you know, have the best sound possible and play the riffs perfectly. But this time around, we still wanted it to feel more like a live experience. So you know, we didn't try to play it perfectly, but rather to play it with a certain, you know, groove to make it feel natural and organic almost.
Yeah, and I think that's really what I appreciate most about the album, is because, just like you said, it does really have that live feel behind it. And even if there are mistakes of any kind or anything, I mean, I'd rather have like a real human, organic kind of album rather than have an album where everything is completely perfect and stale.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, and we did that. I mean, we have done that already in the past. And I mean, it was fine then, but now we wanted to try something different. You know, and I think we succeed.
Oh, absolutely. And, you know, along with that, when it comes into the recording, I mean, of course, so much of it was done within the band, but it's great to see that you were able to get Dan Swano to be able to help master the album and really make it sound the best that it could be.
Yeah, that was really cool for us. I mean, I've always wanted to work with him since, you know, back in the 90s. But for some reason, it was never possible to schedule it, or, you know, the timing wasn't right. So to finally be able to have him work on the album as well was really cool. So it was very, very, very nice.
Oh, definitely. And he's one of my favorite musicians, one of my favorite production guys when it comes into metal music. And yeah, being able to see that you can add him now, being able to help contribute to this album and just make it sound the way that it does, is so cool. And I'm glad to see that you felt the same way that I do, too. I mean, the fact that you wanted to work with him for so long, and now you finally got to be able to say that you worked with him now.
Yeah, I mean, it was kind of a bucket list thing, and to finally do that, and also to work with Christian, who did the cover artwork as well. That was very good. So now I have my list is getting smaller.
Oh yeah, and I'm just about to ask about the artwork too, because I really do love the way that it looks. I mean, it looks so haunting, and I really love the use of the colors and everything that's going along with it. It just has this great drab feel to it. Like, how did it come together, being able to have the album cover come out like this?
Well, I mean, actually Central Media suggested that we should ask if he was available. And luckily for us, he was, you know. He asked us, you know, what the title of the album was, and if I could tell him a little bit about the lyrics. So I told him about the title song and what it's about, and he said, "Yeah, that's awesome. I think I can definitely make something out of that." I think he succeeded, you know, really well to portray the atmosphere on the album.
Yeah, I completely agree with that. And it's, again, with the legendary work between both of those that we were just talking about, between Dan Swano and now, and talking about Christian here, and just looking back at everything that they've done and being able to help contribute to this album. I mean, it's great to be able to see from you guys getting together and being able to make these songs the best that they can be, to having it mastered by one of the best, having an album cover by one of the best metal designers out there. I mean, just everything that came together like that into this complete package. package. And yeah, I mean, just even though the circumstances of the world right now, I imagine, are pretty hard right now for everybody that's going on, especially when being able to try to promote physical copies of the album, I'm glad to see that everything did in fact come together this way. And when you do get a physical copy of this album, I just imagine looking at it and being able to hear that sound is just incredible.
Yeah, I mean, as a matter of fact, I got the vinyls just a couple of days ago, so it was a very special experience to open it up.
Oh, for sure. And of course, another way to be able to promote the album is, of course, singles. And obviously, again, since Terrace, a lot of things have changed when it comes to being able to release singles, and the rise of like lyric videos and visuals instead of just like doing a full blown music video. So, with that in mind, I mean, what was it like to be able to do both this time around, being able to have real videos and also have like these visual videos as well?
Well, I mean, it felt natural to do that, as it's a good way to promote the album, you know, to create that build up. So it felt very nice. I mean, especially for doing the videos with Jacob from Audivan Films, who directed the two regular music videos we did. That was cool. I think he also managed to visualize what we were going after in the music.
Yeah, and especially when it comes on to the two full-blown videos, I really love the atmosphere between both of them. And again, like the use of colors, I mean, like with a Vortex of Negativity, I really love the way that it just has like this really dark mystique behind it. And, you know, with the title track as well, too, being able to see that like in that full 4K view of it as well. I mean, both of them are very beautiful and haunting in different ways.
Yeah, I mean, Jacob is a very good like that, you know. I also one of those bucket list things to be able to work with him, so that was cool.
Oh, yeah. And, you know, with that in mind, too, I mean, being able to cross off so many names when it comes to being able to have that bucket list and being able to have these great people being able to work with this album. I mean, when you're looking back at, like, that final product, I mean, what are you thinking now when it's 2020 now? You got, like, the final vinyl version of the album and you're able to think about how this all came together. I mean, where do you think that how do you feel about the album now and where the band could go in the future?
Well, I mean, as I said, it's that sense of relief and pride. Actually, I mean, where we go in the future, I think we're gonna keep on doing what we always did, is write music whenever time allows us to, and go out there and play. That's actually what I'm looking forward to the most right now, is for this to blow over or to be under control, so we will be able to go back out and play music again, because that's what's most important for me, I think.
Oh, yeah. And, you know, from the fan perspective as well, too, I mean, I can't wait for you guys to be able to get out there and being able to show these songs off live. And just like we were talking about, this album just feels like from start to finish, it just has that live feel behind it. And it'll be so incredible to be able to finally hear you guys get on stage and hear what these songs are going to sound like in that live setting.
Yeah, I mean, we're looking forward to it for sure.
Oh, definitely. And again, you know, it's just there's so much to look forward to after this pandemic eventually dies down and we're able to appreciate live shows again, being able to go to music stores and pick up physical copies of albums again, rather than just getting it through a mail order or the internet, and, you know, just being able to, you know, experience a somewhat of a normal life again. And, you know, just the fact that there's been such a legendary legacy that's going on with the band, and being able to see this all coming back after nearly a decade now, at least from the fan perspective, nearly a decade, seeing everything come together like this. And, Yeah, I'm so excited again to be able to talk to you about all of this, being a longtime fan of the band and being able to see where you guys are at now, and just knowing that even though circumstances are different now when it comes into lives and everything that goes into it, the fact that you're able to put out such killer music, work with such great people, and, you know, eventually when the live shows do happen again, being able to do that as well, it's great to see that the band is going as strong as it is in 2020, and hopefully by 2021 or whatever the case is, the band will be able to come back in as much of a full force as you can be.
Yeah, I mean, that is our intention, so yeah.
Oh, just so cool. And, you know, I think that's an amazing note to end on. And again, thank you very much for taking the time to be able to talk to me about everything that's going on in your world right now. And of course, the brand new album available now through Century Media. I love this album from start to finish. Everything that has gone into this album, and knowing that it did still come out in 2020 when so many other albums are getting delayed, possibly even canceled, and just having an album like this during these times is a great way to be able to get some great emotions out there, and just being able to hear you guys back in top form like this, and looking forward to see what you guys do in the future when it comes to Century Media and live shows and everything going like that. It was an absolute pleasure to be able to talk to you, and I thank you very much for your time.
Yeah, man, thank you for having us on, man, and we appreciate it.
Oh, not a problem. Before we wrap up, is there anything else you'd like to mention that I hadn't brought up yet?
No, I think we covered the most parts. It's maybe just go out and listen to the songs. That's it.